Welcome to Unit 5.6. In the following two units of this chapter, we want to talk about forbidden symmetry and the discovery of the so-called quasicrystals, which is a very exciting story in the recent history of natural science. During the course, we already spoke several times about the restrictions of rotational symmetry that can occur in crystals. To recap, in crystals, the order of rotational symmetry is restricted to 1 to 4 and 6. This is valid concerning the pure rotations, and this is also valid if you look at screw axes, which also can only have orders from 1 to 4 and 6. This was a 100% accepted doctrine in crystallography, a paradigm. And the reason for the existence of these restrictions is that other orders of rotational symmetry, for instance 5, 7, 8, but also 21 or 145, are incompatible with a pattern of strictly periodic lattices. Let's check if this is true. We can try to build a lattice with fivefold rotational symmetry. Here we see something like a centered cell of a two-dimensional lattice with fivefold rotational symmetry. This means the green spheres should represent lattice points. We can draw the lattice vectors pointing from one lattice point to the next one in the A and in the B direction. So now we can translate this lattice along these vectors and should then find a congruent pattern. Let's do it. Translation along A. Does not really look like a congruent pattern. Perhaps we can try to translate it along this direction from the lattice point in the center to a lattice point at the corner. That also doesn't work. So, you see, a fivefold rotational symmetry is incompatible with a repetitive, strictly periodic lattice. This can also be shown for rotational orders higher than 6. This crystallographic paradigm is sometimes also geometrically illustrated by tilings or tessellations. And the question is, if we only allow one sort of tiles, which tiles can completely fill the plane by joining them together side by side? And the answer is again only those with a rotational symmetry of 1, 2, 3, 4 and 6. Tiles with 5-fold, 7-fold, 8, 10 or 12-fold rotational symmetry do not cover the whole floor. Gaps between the tiles remain. Before we go ahead, let me shortly try to make clear once again the difference between the symmetry of the lattice and the symmetry of the motifs. It is, of course, possible to build up a lattice with motifs which show rotational symmetry of the order 5 or 7 or 9, as you can clearly see here in this picture. Okay, and now we write the year 1982. This scientist comes into play, Dan Schechtman from Israel. He worked on the development of several new alloys, searching for new materials for the aeronautical industry. And he obtained some samples, in fact, very small ones, which he investigated by a diffraction technique, namely electron diffraction. This technique was relatively new at that time, but the physical principles are the same as in a widely used and well-established comparable technique with X-rays. So only some few words about this X-ray diffraction technique. Everyone knows X-ray pictures in a medical context. But if you investigate not a broken leg, but single crystals, the X-ray beam, which hits the crystal, is not only diffusively scattered, it is diffracted in a specific way. The X-ray beams interfere in a specific way when passing through the crystal, giving rise to constructive and deconstructive interferences depending on the structure of the crystal. And only at a few places behind the crystal we can see on a photosensible screen the so-called diffraction spots, or reflections, which builds a specific pattern. From the geometry, from the symmetry of this pattern, and intensities of these spots, crystallographers are able to resolve the atomic structure of the crystal. And in principle, electron diffraction works in the same way. The most important thing now is the symmetry of the crystal is reflected in the symmetry of the diffraction pattern. This means, if the crystal shows hexagonal symmetry, then the diffraction pattern also shows this symmetry. And now, what Dan Schechtman saw when he performed the electron diffraction experiments with his new alloys was something like that. He couldn't believe his eyes. A diffraction pattern with tenfold rotational symmetry. And also these local fivefold patterns are clearly visible. Skeptical, Schechtman wrote in his lab journal, tenfold? Could he have found a new state of matter? A crystal with forbidden symmetry? How should something like this be possible? Stay tuned, the story will continue in the next unit.